Hi guys, hello. Sorry, I'm a little late. We had some problem, but we did and we solved. So, hello there. The second week of the Download Festival is just begun, and we had a lot of interesting session last week, and the same I'm sure will be for this second one. Today, I'm here to share with you in the spirit of the Download Festival and inspiring use cases that is focused on analytics on Amazon Web Services. But first, I need to say thank you to my Sorinth colleagues that took care of all the organization and also the stuff that the problem that I had today to connect with you to this session. And thank you guys, you have been amazing. And also I want to say thank you to Jacopo Zaccariotto, that is the team leader of the team of data engineering of the company where we developed the application that I'm going to show you. So now, okay, let me briefly introduce myself. I am Claudia Sacco. I am a PhD engineer graduated at the University of Salerno with the passion of climbing, and I am a Sorinthian, so I work in Sorinth Tech, that is the business unit of Sorinth Lab Group, focused on the development of advanced analytics and machine learning solution applied to both IoT, industry 4.0, and smart city. And in the last 3 years, I've been working on design and development of enterprise architecture for data analytics on the main cloud computing provider. And in this speech, I'm going to discuss about the design principles and criteria of a well-architected solution using both theory and some practical example. So let's start from the index of the content. First, we are going to define what we meaning when we refer to data analytics. Then we will see what cloud computing is and what is Amazon Web Services. After, we will overview the data analytics core services that AWS offers to us. And then we will focus on the pillar and the design principle of the well-architected framework. And finally, we will see an enterprise data analytics application on the AWS. So let's start. Okay, so what does it mean data analytics? Well, usually data analytics and data analysis are often treated like interchangeable terms, but they hold a slightly different meaning. Essentially, in my opinion, the primary difference between analytics and analysis is a matter of skill. As data analytics is a broader term, so which data analysis is a subcomponent. So as you can read here from the definition of Gartner glossary that I reported in this slide, data analytics is an overarching science discipline that encompasses the complete management of the data. And the root of the data analytics is the identification of the business questions. So starting from the problem that the business is trying to solve, data analytics works to find business answer. But how? Well, if we open the box of the data analytics process, we can see that it includes many subcomponents that we can summarize in collect, store, process, and analyze subcomponent. So we can go now a little deeper. I promise that all this theory will be useful for us to understand the next and practical slides. And so we can define a little more in depth these single terms. So the collect, the subcomponent collect is the subcomponent in which we import and transfer the data for later user and also for to store them. The data collection involves connecting to different data sources, for example, relational databases or web blog, or as we will see, application log or social media. And the collect subcomponent deals not only to extract the data, but also to detect the change that happen inside the data. The store subcomponent is the subcomponent that is aimed to persistently storing and managing the data. When we design this subcomponent, we have to take in mind some issue, for example, related with the compliance, in order to define, for example, the life cycle of the data, for example, how long have we to retain the data? Or, for example, do we need to store the original content of the data? Etc. Moving ahead, we have the process subcomponent. Here we clean the data, the raw data, that we collected, and prepare for the data set for the further steps, also using some technology of extracting, transforming, and loading process, also known as ETL. Finally, we have the analyze subcomponent. In this subcomponent, we can inspect, can model the data with the goal of discovering the useful information and available conclusion gives business answer to support decision making, also sharing this conclusion with the data visualization tool and the BI tool. Here I'd like to stress that data analytics is an iterative and recursive process. So, for example, while we are inspecting the data, we need to collect other data to enrich the model and provide our business answer. So now let's take the first step to move from theory to practice. Let's imagine that we work in a company that, for example, is one of the leading company in the field of solutions that helps organization to digitalize their business. So the business team of this company want to be sure that the digital product that they sell are compliant with the signed service level agreement. So now we have our business question, and to answer to this business question, the next step is how can we build our data analytics solution? Well, so we have to move from the raw data, we have to collect them in order to give this answer to business. Well, the data analytics solution relies on the main IT resources that we can briefly summarize in compute, memory, network, and storage resources, to which we can refer briefly in terms of infrastructure. Traditionally, each enterprise owned its own infrastructure inside an on-premises data center. But unfortunately, data center brings some disadvantage. Like, for example, we have to pay for the rent of the data center, the power supply, cooling, maintenance. So we have to afford a capital expense in order to build our data center. Moreover, we have to hire 24 hours by day to monitor our infrastructure, and we have to design the data center for scaling and also for scaling out, we hope, for our application and for disaster recovery. So to deal with this problem, to solve this problem, many enterprises now use cloud computing. That is the on-demand delivery of the infrastructure, and more, much more in terms also of application or also software, is this provide the providing of these IT resources on demand. And with the cloud computing, we can have we can gain many advantages. Like, for example, we can trade our capital expense for operational expense. We can stop to guess the capacity, so we can easily, for example, scale out our application, or also scale in our application depending on our business. And we can benefit from the global infrastructure of our cloud provider in terms of both speed and agility in the developing of our application, but also in terms of economy related to the costs related to our application. So the next step is, what is AWS? AWS? AWS Amazon Web Services, is one of the world's most comprehensive and broadly adopted cloud provider. So Gartner, in its Magic Quadrant for Cloud Infrastructure and Platform Services, placed AWS as a leader, both for its high ability to execute and completeness of vision. So now we can discover a bit more this cloud provider for focusing on this feature. So what does it mean, ability to execute? We can link this ability to the AWS global infrastructure. This infrastructure, as you can see from the picture, is made of region. The region is the top level of the AWS cloud infrastructure, and each region is a cluster of the data centers. Each region, the region are connected to each other by the AWS private network. And as we will see, most of the services that AWS offers to us are region specific. And so when we have to design our application, we have to take this in mind, considering, for example, compliance constraint, and also, for example, customer proximity to this region, if you want, for example, to minimize latency of our application. But if we zoom in AWS region, we can see that each region, we can find availability zone. Each availability zone is one or more discrete data center with redundant power, networking, and connectivity. As each availability zone is isolated from each other, they are the building blocks to build applications that are resilient to disaster. So now we have understood what does it mean ability to execute, but AWS is a leader also in completeness of vision. And I think that this slide easily show you why. Well, AWS has more than 2,000 services and even more and more resources related that are child, we can see, of these services that span from infrastructure as a services to platform and also to software as a services. Of course, these services span in order to cover our needs in terms of development of mobile services, game development, enterprise application, and many other fields of application. And of course, I think that now that here we can take in mind the EC2 services, that is the services that is related with the compute in AWS, and also IAM, the identity and access management services related to the security management of the one of the aspects of the security and the identity in AWS, and also management tool like, for example, CloudFormation and CloudWatch. These services that I've mentioned, we can take these services in mind because, as we will see, to design a data analytics application that can be used in production, we need to enforce this application also with some other services that allow us to bring this application to an enterprise level. So now let's move to briefly discover what are the data analytics for core services in AWS. So we can start to assemble our to build our application analytics application. So the first subcomponent that we can consider is the store. So the leader solution in AWS is the services of simple storage services, aka S3. S3 is used for obviously a wide range of use. For example, we can build data lake, we can use it to build website, mobile application, and big data analytics. The main resources that these services provide to us are the bucket, S3 bucket, the container for our object, and the object that is the file and its metadata that contains our data. Here, as we told, when we store our data, we need to think about life cycle management of our data. That in AWS offer us some feature associated with the bucket that are the storage classes that allows us to define the life cycle of our object. So now move on and let's see which services can we consider in order to build our data analytics, the subcomponent of collect inside our data analytics solution. Well, we can use both AWS Data Pipeline, which is a web service that helps us to move data between different AWS compute and storage services, both on-premises and on the cloud. And you can use Amazon Kinesis. Amazon Kinesis allows us to process and also analyze in real time with Kinesis Analytics. Kinesis Analytics, our streaming data. So we can get timely insights and react quick to new information. So with these services, we can ingest data real time, such for example video with the Kinesis video stream and application log, as we will see, website click stream, and also IoT telemetry for machine learning. Both using Amazon Kinesis Firehose and Amazon Kinesis Analytics. Well, I think that it's worth spend some words to distinguish between these two services, because what happened to my okay, sorry. Can someone can hear me? I don't know. I think that my webcam is still online. Okay, I think that I am online. Okay, so I can move on. Okay, so the main difference between these two services relies on three features. That is the level of management of the service that we want to carry on us, the destination of our stream, and the time of response to the new data. Why? Because, for example, if we use Amazon Kinesis streams, we work in real time, but we have to design and scale on our own the stream, but we can consume our data to any destination. If we use Amazon Kinesis delivery stream, we have a delivery stream that works in real time, so we have a buffer interval that have to be in our application that have to be longer than 60 seconds, and the delivery is fully managed by AWS, but we can store your data with our data only in S3, Redshift, Elasticsearch, or Splunk. Last thing, because we will use it in our application, you have many ways to ingest your data inside the stream of Kinesis, inside the Kinesis Firehose delivery stream or Kinesis Firehose Kinesis data stream. The one of the most used is to install a Kinesis agent on the server from which we want to ingest our data. Next subcomponent is this process, is the process subcomponent. The services that AWS gives to us are mainly of two types, that is Amazon EMR and AWS Glue. And as we will see, we will use both of these services inside our data analytics application. The first one, Amazon EMR, is a cloud big data platform for processing vast amount of data using, for example, Apache Spark, Apache Hive, and etc. When it's worth to say to you that when we use these services, we have to provision our cluster. That means that we have to to choose the infrastructure that we want to use. So we need to have information about the kind of instance that we want to use to build our cluster. The second one, the second tool for data processing is AWS Glue, which is a fully managed ETL that we can use to prepare our dataset. The main resources that I think is worth to mention here are Crawler, which allow us to automatically discover the schema for our data, and the Data Catalog, which allow us to have comprehensive that metadata store for all the data that we can store inside our cloud. Finally, we have the analyze subcomponent. Here we found, of course, a lot of services that AWS offered to us. We have, first of all, Amazon Athena. Amazon Athena is an interactive query services that allows you to analyze data in Amazon S3 using standard SQL. Then we have Amazon Redshift. Amazon Redshift is the offer of it's the service that AWS suggests if you want to build your data warehouse. Using which you can analyze all your data using both standard SQL and existing BI tool. And we have also another services that is Amazon QuickSight, which is a cloud-powered business intelligence tool that allows us to create interactive dashboard that can be accessed from browser on mobile device. We can have also other services for example text research, like for example Amazon Elasticsearch services provided by AWS. So now we have seen the core services that AWS offered to us to build the subcomponent for our data analytics application. I would like to say that I mentioned only the really core solution of that AWS give us, but basing on the need of our application, we can take advantage of many other services that AWS gives to us. For example, to move our data, we can use also Snow Mobile if we have to ingest a giant data set. And of course, we can use, for example, all the services that are related with the databases solution on AWS. It depends on the needs of our applications. So for our needs, the solution that we designed is built for considering only the data analytics core services, core architecture, is made by this subcomponent. We have installed an EC2 on an EC2 instance the Kinesis agent, which takes care to gives to our delivery stream, Kinesis delivery stream, the weblog And Kinesis, the Kinesis delivery stream that, as we now we know, is a fully managed stream by AWS, we can store our data in our store layer. And from this layer, we can process our data using in batch our web log by using a cluster, an EMR cluster that we designed using the EC2 services. After that, we have cleaned our data, our raw data, so the web log that we ingested, we can take the data, we can define using AWS Glue and its crawler and its data catalog, we can define the table and the database and the table, the schema of the informations that we need to explore in the subcomponent, analyze the subcomponent. And for this purpose, we used Amazon Athena that allows us, as now we already know, to perform interactive query directly on Amazon S3. So we can build our model in order to find the business answer or that is the service level agreement starting from the application weblog. But this solution is made of only the services related with the data analytics subcomponent. So we need to enrich this application in order to take this application on a production environment and let this application become an enterprise data analytics solution. So to do this, we can follow 5 pillars and their design principle in order to enrich our architecture. So the first one is the operational excellence. Operational excellence includes the ability to run and monitor system to deliver business value and to continually improve supporting process and procedure. Well, how does this sentences can be translated in design principle? First of all, we could translate all the operation in coding. So the infrastructure, the main design principle of this pillar is infrastructure as code. So as we will see, we have some tool, some AWS service that can be used to this aim. Another, for example, design principle could be make frequent, small and reversible changes in order to allow us to come back if any failures occur. The second pillar is represented by security. Security includes the ability to protect informations, systems and assets while delivering business value through risk assessment and mitigation strategy. How can we translate again this sentence in design principle? What this design principle should be? For example, identify a strong identity foundation. As we can see, we have in AWS services that allow us to manage access and identity to our services. For example, we can use the least privilege principle. We can protect our data while they are in transit, for example, using SSL, or while they are at rest, for example, using encryption. And it sounds not so good to say, but we should keep people away from our data. For example, we can define a policy that allows access to our data and allow action on our data only to authorized and entrusted application and user. The third pillar is the reliability. Reliability is the ability of a system to recover from infrastructure or service disruption, dynamically acquiring computing resources to meet the demand and mitigate disruption such as misconfiguration or transient network issues. So, in simple words, whatever it happens, our application needs to run, and the design principle that we can take in mind, trying to apply this pillar is, for example, to test recovery procedures. So, for example, use automation to simulate different failure or recreate a scenario of failure. And another design principle can be using auto-scaling, so scale horizontally in case we need to increase our availability of our aggregate system, and stop to guess the capacity, but trust in the auto-scaling feature that AWS gives to us. The fourth pillar is the performance efficiency. Well, performance efficiency includes the ability to meet requirement to maintain that efficiency as demand change and the technology evolves. How can we implement the design principle in order to achieve this performance efficiency? Well, we can use advanced technology and be a mechanical sympathy that it's one of the most difficult things in AWS, as everyday new services and resources are offered. And another design principle can be use serverless architecture. Serverless architecture, we can see, doesn't mean that we don't have servers, but that AWS takes care of the management of these services. And for example, this can avoid us to burden of managing this service, for example, if we want to scale. So if you use a serverless architecture, everything can scale automatically. And of course, the last pillar is cost optimization. Cost optimization includes the ability to run a system to deliver business value at lower price point. The design principle can be adopt a consumption model, so pay only for what you use, and use managed application, because in managed services can evolve, can scale, and of course the cost that we can that we have to deal with are only related with the load that the application have to effort related with the growth of our business. So now let's see how our how we used these 5 pillars in order to transform our data analytics solution in a well architected data analytics solution, an enterprise data analytics solution. So for operational excellence, we used CloudFormation. At the beginning of this session, I mentioned to you, these services allow us to implement infrastructure as code using a template. So we can manage all our services and infrastructure code by coding, for example, by using a YAML file or a JSON file. We can implement security pillar by using IAM identity and access management tool that AWS gives to us, and also STS services. And for example, assigning role and to our application that are scoped to the action that they have to take. We implemented the reliability by monitoring constantly our application, watching metrics, for example, for our delivery stream. And we designed performance efficiency by using Lambda to avoid the burden of managing server, and so everything because Lambda can automatic scale based on the load that our application has. And finally, we performed cost optimization by using one particular model of spot of EC2 instance that are spot instance. So see how our application changed now that we implemented this pillar in order to have an enterprise data analytics solution. As you can see in green, there are all the services that are not scoped to data analytics core solution, but that allows us to build and to develop an application, an enterprise data analytics solutions. So as you can see here, all the infrastructure has been designed and also deployed using AWS CloudFormation, so these management services. So using the template, we can deliver the stack that has all the resources. For example, the delivery stream, the Lambda, the elements of the data catalog, the crawler that we use in order to perform our data analytics solution. Inside our data analytics solution, we applied the security pillar by using IAM and defining role that allows our application, our delivery stream, to write only, for example, in the one bucket that we defined. So we controlled the allowed action that this application can perform by using IAM. Referring to the to the data, to the subcomponent of the process subcomponent, we optimized the application by using temporary cluster, temporary EMR cluster that that has a spot instance. So we can enhance the cost optimization, and is triggered by a lambda function, and the lambda function is triggered by an event of CloudWatch, or also Event Bridge. That triggers also the component of the other process component that is our crawler. And finally, all these applications focusing on the pillar of the reliability has been monitored using CloudWatch, a log stream that is built inside a CloudWatch log group, which is connected, which monitors the stream in terms of bytes that are written inside the bucket, destination bucket in our S3 services, and that triggers an alarms when something wild happens to our delivery streams, and these alarms triggers an email using another services that is another resources that is the topic of SNS services of AWS. Let's think what happens if business asks to us to add and to monitor and to give them answer about another Slack. Well, now that our application is built using five pillar, we of course use operation, excellent operation. So this means that our infrastructure is coded. That means that we can just update our template in order to deploy another Kinesis Firewall, another CloudWatch log stream, another alarms, and all other components, like for example crawler, and that we need in order to provide answer to business. And I'm proud to say that this event not occurred just only once or two times, but it has been occurred 8 times. And so we gained a lot of time and made very, very few efforts to let this data analytics application grow as the business asked for more information. So before the last thanks, I want I think that it's worth mentioning that, as you can see, the building and the design of this application requires a lot of skill. For example, the information about the business logic by which we can take the raw data and clean it and process the data and put it inside our bucket needs big data development skills. The process to analyze the data in order to build the business model needs skills related to the ability to to build data modeling. And so I would like also to thank you for the building of this application, my colleagues Simone Cardi, Silvia Lena and Silvia Borkowska, because we worked together in order to deliver this this application. And as we can see, many skills put together can bring the better results. So thank you guys for the time that you give to me to present our case. And I will, if you have any answer, I will wait for you in the room in order to give you questions like data analytics solution. Thank you. Bye.